kale mukama mulungi onakulwa letu lina
today
tulina delivery service
we have a delivering service
era insomolachi tu wandene service emu
and it's the reason as to why we are going to have one service in the morning
njagala mbayitire muko
I want to take you through
gwachi tuba ne deliverance
the reason as to why rush to berano kusumulura
not all balokole churches believe in deliverance
sinti buli makanisa gonaga abalokole gakiririza mukusumulura
so many people don't believe
abantu banji tebakiriza
I think it is because of ignorance
ndoza rabutamanya
we have to teach people
tuino kuyigiriza abantu
amen we have amen. To teach people
tuino kuyigiriza abantu
yes you can be saved
osobola kubera omulokole
but when you are in bondage
nengate oli musibe
I'm going to talk about bondage
ngenda kogera ku busibe
and captivity
nobuwambe
I want you people to notice the difference between bondage and captivity
njagala mulabe wokko kunja wolo wakati wo busibe nobuwambe
amen
amen
and know
era mumanye
why
rachi
a born again
omulokole
can move under bondage
asobola kutambulira wansi wo busibe
praise the lord
amen
let me first explain this
kansoke mba nyonyore kino
bondage
obusibe
is a state of being a slave
yembera eyokubera omuddu
it is a state
yembera
being a slave
ngwa omuntu muddu
you may not be a slave
oyinza obutabera muddu
but if you are in the state
nebo bango obulambo buli mombera eyokubera omuddu
kizibu nyo
it is very difficult
and a slave
ato omuddu
is being someone's legal property
kwekuberanga oli property yomuntu mu mateeka
and forced to obey them
erango okakibwa okubagondera
a slave
omuddu
a slave
omuddu
is being someone's legal property
kwekuberanga omuntu yakugula ngoli uwe mu mateeka
in those days
munakwezo
zebagulilanga mu abaddu
where there was a slavery and
someone goes in the market of slaves
omuntu agenda mukatale akabaddu
pays his money
nasasura sente ze
then nalioka akuyita
and then they call
no
you
jawaka.
And you come home
you work for that person
nokolera omuntu oyo
amen
amen
till you die
pakabofa
no payment
ngate wali kusasura
you are like an animal
olinge ensoro
praise the lord
amen
so as a slave
kati omuddu
is a state of being bound
yemberanga oli musibe
or subjected to some external power or control
obanga wali wa amanya gatali gagonga gega kufuga
amen
amen
a certain power
amanyi
ngagega kufuga
this power controls you
praise the lord
amen
so for instance
okugeza
obera unga oli musibe
you're there and you're bound you're tied up you're in chains
nenga akufuga ono yakufuga nenga oli musibe
but this person has control over you but you're bound
amen
amen
a state of a slavery still
okubera
obuddu it is a state of being under the control of another person
kokuberanga oli wansi w'obufuzi bw'omuntu omulala
amen
amen
ayinza kuba a spiritual force
omuntu ono gayinza kubanga manyi
gamoyo
oba omuntu golabira ko ddala
naye nga ye ali awo you are in control
ya kufuga
amen
amen
to still
okumbuddu
to be in bondage
okubera mu busibe
means disabled
chitegeza nti oyina byota sobola oyi wasanyalala
incapable
obera tosobola
immobile
nga tosobola kuva mu kifo kimu kugenda walala
amen
amen
still to be in bondage
okubera mbusibe
is to be enslaved physically
kwe kubera nga mubuliwo oli musibe oli muddu
and spiritually
ne mu moyo ngoli muddu
in all spheres of life
mu bitundu byonna ebyobulamu
is the inability to fulfill one's dreams and visions of life
era embere eno bwokubera nga tosobola kutukiriza biroto byona kwolesebwako mbulamu
praise the lord
amina
Brothers and sisters,
Aboluganda,
there are many people who are born again,
abalokole,
but
they are in such a state.
They can't fulfill their dreams. Yet they are born again. They wait for their dreams come to pass till they die without seeing their promise, the promises of God. And so many backslide and leave God because they begin to see God as someone who is not faithful. But the fact is, it is
because they are in bondage.
But I have good news from the Old Testament. God hates slavery. You remember, before even Jesus came, God thought about his people. They were in slavery in Egypt and said, I will send a redeemer. I will send Moses to break that slavery. I want my people to come out from bondage. I want them to live a free life. This is what happened in the Old Testament. God came down, delivered his children. In the same way, you can be a child of God, but in bondage, a slave of someone. You can't fulfill your dreams. You
are
a child of God. You sing about the blood, but you can't fulfill your dreams. I'm here to tell you that our God can set you free and give you a new song. Amen.
Amina.
Now let me first talk briefly about captivity.
Katika nsoke njogere mu bimpipi ku buwambe.
Bila bikange bifanagana.
They look similar,
but they are not the same.
Na yate sibi ebimu.
Captivity.
Obuwambe.
It is a condition of being imprisoned or confined.
Yembera eyokubera nga osibiddwa awantu nga tokirizibwa kuvaawo.
It is a situation in which a person or an animal is kept somewhere and not allowed to leave.
Yembera omuntu obensoro nga ina bwakumiddwa era nga takirizibwa kuvaawo.
With slavery,
obuddu,
you're
bound with chains on your legs or anywhere.
They command you to do what you don't want.
Bakulagira okole kyotayagala kola.
Nebuno obuwambe.
But captivity.
Banza nokusibira wakao ne bakugamba, you are not supposed to live beyond, to move beyond your gate.
They may even keep you at your home and they tell you to kill
you. You are not a slave
kuva mu gate yo.
But you have limited space.
Tori muddu naye okomezeka.
There is a confinement on your life.
Waliwo obusibe oba waliwo okomya okuli ku bulamu obwo.
Birabikange bifanagana.
They look the same.
Naye kiri eky'obuddu kyo kiba kya buddu baba baakugula.
But the other issue of slavery, you were bought.
Naye ate kino ekya captivity.
But the issue eky'obuwambe.
Kyo bakuwamba.
For it, you are taken as a captive. Someone can bewitch you and then they confine you in one place. You're not bound.
You are not a slave.
Tori muddu.
No one bought you.
Tewari yakugula.
But you are confined somewhere. You are on that level.
You educated, but you're there. You don't progress.
There are some demons which keep you on that level. You are not allowed to go until you get an external power which can help you to break the bondage, to break the walls. That is when you can move out and run out, because you are not a slave. You don't have chains on your legs. Amen. So captivity. captivity is a situation in which a person or an animal is kept somewhere and not allowed to leave. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
A person or an animal whose abilities is to move freely is limited by keeping them somewhere like in a prison. Do you get the difference? So, captivity,
bunobuwambe.
Bondage, bubabusibe.
Bondage, you're tied up.
Erano musibe abaya wambiwa.
And even a prisoner is taken captive.
Nayaba, kenjegere.
They have chains.
Abamudu.
A slave is.
Aba akolera oye yamugula.
They are working for the one who bought them.
Kachitegeza.
So it means.
Nti captivity omuntu bwabanga tebajangu yide.
If people don't come quickly and save someone from captivity, they may become a slave.
You get the difference? Now, today, in the afternoon, we are going to come back here and trust God to break the captivity upon our lives and the bondage. For
us in this ministry,
I can look at you and understand.
Some people
are not slaves. Are not in bondage. But they are in captivity. You look at that person. He was able to study. He can get sugar and food. He can teach. His children at a certain level. That is captivity. When I look at you and understand, I know what to do. Many people, when they come in counseling, they are experiencing bad situations. But I tell them that there is no curse on you.
But pastor, if there's no curse upon my life, then why are these things happening?
Because
those things are happening. Kubanga, you are a captive. If you're taken as a captive, I know what to do.
I can get armies from heaven.
Come
down. Pick you from that captivity.
And then we take you out.
Most people are like that.
Abantu abo bali webatyo.
But there are other people.
Naye ate waliwo abantu abalala.
Nga okuva mu kuwambibwa.
Like out of captivity.
Basirevu si.
Baddu.
Gutumanyi gubaita slave.
You don't know whom they call a slave.
Bamusibe mikono.
Their hands are tied up.
Namaguru.
Their legs are tied up.
Baba atambula.
When they are walking.
Kubanga kulukuluje enjegere ziri kuna akola steps.
Their chains are on their legs, they take steps.
Because of what? Because of the chains. Amen.
Amen.
When
they get to where they are going to work from.
The master, the one who
bought them, says, carry this log, even if they can't handle it.
Kat Satan.
So the devil.
Can be, when
he bought your family from your ancestor.
Actually, naba slaves bazaala.
Even slaves give birth.
Naibu aba azadda abana.
But if a slave gives birth to children.
Era oyo mukama ugwakolera abafunyimu.
That the master.
Abana abera nabo bakula.
The master has benefited. When those children grow up, they also become slaves. They start being like their dad. If he gives birth to like 6 children, it's like you've had 1 cow and it gives
you
birth to 8
more
calves.
More milk.
So even the one who bought you says, now, master, today you may rest, let your sons go to the garden. They even give them a house. So a time comes, and they're like, you see, your age, sit and let the children work.
This is what I mean.
Chino chentegeza. You can be bound, and your children can also be bound. And even the next generation can be bound.
I'm talking about bondage. the devil can enslave the whole family until you trust the Holy Spirit to set you free. Now the Bible says, and it was a prophet Isaiah who gave this prophecy, and he said that on that day the burden will follow from his shoulders. These slaves carry burdens. They are a beast of burdens. Amen. They carry big logs. But the prophet said that on that day the burden will follow from his shoulders because of the anointing. When the anointing comes, it breaks and destroys the yoke, the chains, and the slaves becomes free. A slave can run away if there is no chain. You begin to make big steps.
Oh,
a big step. Oyinza okubanga obadde luli otambula bwoti kubanga olina olujegere ebigere baabisiba tosobola kola kintu kya mitwalo asatu naye enjegere bwe zikutuka 2 million, 10 million, 30 million. But the Holy Spirit can do that. Whenever we come to church, we believe God for the Holy Spirit to set us free. There are so many Christians who are still in captivity. They are bound. They are bound, but they don't know.
They're waiting. But things will never come forth.
Why?
Rachi.
They don't teach them.
Kubanga.
They are not taught.
Tebayigiriziddwa.
Bible says my people perish.
Bible gamata abantu bange bazikirira.
Ani ayogera?
Who says Katonda?
My people perish.
Abantu bange bazikirira.
Because of lack of knowledge.
Olw'okubula okumanya.
You get knowledge from people who know.
Ofuna okumanya okuva mu bantu
abamanyi. We get knowledge from books.
Tufuna okumanya okuva mu bitabo.
You can't tell God, oh God, give me knowledge.
Tosobola gamba Katonda mukama mpo kumanya.
God will never give you knowledge.
Katonda tali kuwa kumanya.
God gives you wisdom.
Katonda kuwa magezi.
But you get knowledge from people who know.
Tufuna okumanya okuva mu bantu abamanyi.
We get knowledge from schools.
Tufuna okumanya okuva mu masomero.
Now I'm giving you knowledge that even if you go to
America,
when you are still bound, a slave can be put on the plane, nave Uganda,
and they move from Uganda,
nagenda mu Washington DC,
and they go to Washington DC. When they come out of the plane, the chains are still on their legs.
You can't run. You can't make big steps because you are bound. Chino chamber.
This is what I'm telling you. Leave Uganda when the chains have been broken.
When you go to Canada, you'll make big steps. But some people think that changing a nation, changing a job, can bring a change in your life. You are deceiving yourself. If you are still bound, even if you work with the President Museveni in the State House,
whatever the money he gives you, that
then the contract expires.
And you've not even built a house.
Praise the Lord. But if
someone has been delivered, the chains have been broken.
Wadembe.
The person is free. Even if they have a small plot of land, they can build a storied house in that plot of land.
Our God is not a respectable person.
Katonda afeta sosola mbantu.
He's not a respectable person.
Katonda afeta sosola mbantu.
Whether you were black,
obori mudugavu,
or a white,
obori muzungu,
a Gentile,
obori
mwamawango,
obori muyudaya,
we are all the same before our God. Fena
tuli chechimu masoga Katonda wafe.
Yes, we are the same.
Fena tuenkanakana.
Obusibu buli ruddawo.
So where is the problem?
Obusibe.
The bondage.
Sitani bwaba asiba.
When the devil is binding
asoka kusiba buongo.
He first binds your mind.
Omuntu ngobongo babusiba.
If someone's mind is bound.
Nebo mwa billion 10.
Even if you give them 10 billion.
Aso zitele kanali yako mpola.
They may keep it and use
na
it slowly.
Ziria.
They use it
until when
they finish it even without building a house. So many people are bound in their minds. When their minds are bound,
confined in one place,
you
can't get new ideas.
Amen.
No new ideas. You can't see good deals. You are in one place. You begin to fear people. That person will never add anything on me.
Your mind can be bound. This person.
The reason why we take children to school.
So that they can have a free mind. The child or an adult, the people around them can bring a bondage without anyone bewitching you. Your mind can be in one place. That is why we tell you, get your money and take your child to school.
And
give them a free school so that they can play with all the other pupils and students, and they can talk to this one and the other.
Weba mixed school.
That is very good. A child grows up when they are confident. They can speak to this one and the other. But you see some children.
They are
only in Buganda. They've never studied with a child from the north or the south or the west.
Confined in one place.
Even when they get a job, they have a problem. Because they studied only from Buganda. They cannot speak with other people. That is also a kind of bondage. But who put them in that bondage? You yourself, the parent. Send your child to speak to all, also other people. Let them be free to talk to the Muslims, the Catholics, the Baganda, the Bachiga, all of them. Let them be able to interact with all people.
Because when you grow up,
you
may not be in Uganda. What will you do when you go to
London?
You never interacted with the whites. If you have an opportunity,
send your child to interact with all people.
Amen.
Amen.
It's good if you are in the village.
That is why chirungi nyo bobera ngoli muchalo.
Omwana mujeko muchalo.
You know, get the child from the village.
Town setting,
and take them to a town setting. Huh?
And let them meet
the different tribes, the different people, so that it helps them. I want you to look and see the children that have been interacting with the different people. Do you see? They have a good life. They don't have a problem. Even if a man is trying to court them and they want to marry them,
if the man is mnyankola and the girl is a musoga,
they have a good.
tamanyi nti Omuganda asobola omuwasa oba omutola asobola omuwasa oba omuki abeera in one place abalala abalaba nga tebasobola ne bwaba amuwadde omulimu awulira nga tajja musasula bulungi obwo nabwo buba busibe
mangi
you meet a church
osinkane kanisa
led by Muganda
nge ekulibwa Muganda
oh the church members abaganda
nga aba member bonabe kanisa bonabaganda
obona bo busibe
that is also bondage
but we go to church because God
tugena mukanisa kubanga
katonda has planted me there
ansimbye wao
that is where I will meet my God
awengendo kusinkanira katonda
that is where my blessing is
awo mukisa gwange weguri
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Genda olaba abantu abafunye omukisa okuinteractinga n'abantu abalala.
Go and see people who have gotten an opportunity to interact with different people.
Balina marriages ennungi.
They are in good marriages.
Balina emirimu emirungi.
They have good jobs.
Amanyi talina limit yonna.
They don't have any limit upon their lives.
Tabela limited by tribe.
Teba fugibwa our tribe.
Amen.
Amen.
Tabela limited by oba gwanga
tubakomezeka gwanga
umuntu wabasomya asobola okufuna omulimu e Nairobi
if someone is educated they can get a job
you
in Nairobi
you work with Kikuyus
no kola naba Kikuyu
happily
gwatoli musanyufu
because there is no limit
kubanga tewali komo
there is no bondage
kubanga tewali busibe
so the people you live with
kati abantu bobera nabo
can put you in bondage
basobola kuteka mbuwambe
oba totegedde bulungi
oba mbusibe if you're not careful
the people
abantu
can affect your mind
basobola kosa ebirowoozo
so you have to be very careful
oyina kubera omwegendereza
praise the lord
amen
make a choice
kolokusalawo
this world is a world of choices
enensi ensi
make a choice
kolokusalawo
bobo yagala okuba bulungi salawo bulungi
you want to be well make a good choice
somero chimuno twala abana bo
you know you which school will you take your children to
this is abantu you have to only muslims
why
umwana we bwana aba akuze ngafuna omulimu
if that child grows up and they are getting a job
anafuna basilamu boka
they get a job only with muslims
these days I've been observing on tv
enako zinobade netegeza
even muslim schools bwabalanga bagamba
na masomero ka basilamu baga they say
we consider even other religions
na madini amanala tugakiriza
and I said wow that is great
echo chirundi
that is great
echo chirundi
but before that
nenge chite chinabawo
other traditional schools
ama somera amalala
used to say if you are not a Catholic
agarudo gaga mangabo banga
you are not allowed in our school
tokirizibwa musomero
lya and we force you to become a Catholic even if you are not that is bondage
obo busibe
Amen.
Amen.
Omwana bwabazza okufuna education.
If a child has come to receive education, give them the education.
Mulekere freedom of worship. Bwaba Muslim mulekaze abere Muslim. Bwaba Catholic abere mu Catholic.
Allow them to be Catholics.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Kati obusibe.
So bondage.
Butandikira mu mind.
Starts with the mind.
Even poverty.
No
omuntu nga a musibengo obuddu bwe yawambibwa
if someone's slavery
obwavu butandikira mind
poverty starts in the mind
mind yo webanga nsibe
if your mind is bound
omunewo mgamba that business will grow
even if you tell someone your business ejakula agamba nedda
elikuladdi
when will it grow
use this little money
cause it's a sentence in entono
slowly by slowly
pola pola
it will grow
Business
this capital will grow
capital na jakula
chovula abantu abamte basobado ku savinga
that is why some people cannot even save
kubanga obwavu bwabawamba
because poverty they are in captivity of poverty
mutunulira abantu bawambe
people are captives
government neba was sent za bajita pichi eh ani parish development modo ogena okuliranga agenze kuwasaba kyala
you hear that they've gone to marry women
ne baba wo butimba bwensiri
they give them mosquito nets
ne babu kolachi ne babu kufumbira mu omwenge bakola kya babu kozi soku vuba ebyennyanja
they use it even the mosquito nets for fishing
Malaria gwe tulwanyisa. Tukuwa katimba kensiri.
Let me give you the mosquito net. Yes.
Abamu bazimba akasisi n'akateeka ebweru bwali.
Some build a hut and then they put the mosquito net on the outside.
N'agamba gezaako kale oyingirewo wano.
They dare even dare enter here.
Obusibe.
The bondage.
Omunomu gamba mire eddagala.
You tell someone swallow medicine.
N'agamba ye doctor njadde mira.
Say yes doctor, I'll swallow the medicine.
Uva unalika sukeri.
Then after they throw it away.
Sisobola kufa.
I cannot die.
Obusibe obwo buli nnyo mbalokole.
That bondage is among the poor.
Tebakkiririza mu malwaliro.
They don't believe in hospitals.
They walk by faith.
Mbu
they walk by faith. They don't want to go to hospitals.
Tebagala genda malwaliro.
They walk by faith.
Batambula na kukkiriza.
Tumanye Katonda kubuli ayiseemu agenda kuwonyeza.
Which way God is going to use to heal you.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God can pass through hospitals. He's the one who gave them wisdom to make that medicine. But people don't want to go to hospitals. Why? We are born again. Why? Why don't you go to the hospital? People don't want to take children to school. Like there are some religions who used to say,
oh,
we can't educate a girl. I can't educate a girl. When I educate a girl, again, they used to give their children
15 years. They used to give their children in marriage at 15 years. That was bondage in their mind.
How do you break the captivity of the mind through teaching? The Bible says, continue in my word, you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. When you get the truth, you are free. That's why you have to make a choice. Amen.
Amen.
Why do born again do a
beautiful thing?
It's part of deliverance. Ever since you started coming to this church, when you see a pastor putting on a nice suit, you begin, the lock begins to break.
I think I should also wear a suit.
When you see a flower here, you admire it, then the captivity is broken. And then you say, nange ninoku cheka flower in my house.
Like I should also have a flower.
When you see things, you admire them.
We are not trying to do this,
but we are breaking the captivity. Put a basket there. Thank you, sister. God bless you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Do you get me?
Montegera.
Do you get me?
Montegera.
Sengan zigira murags.
If I come ganyamba de enzina,
I can still preach.
Nsobolo kubulira.
And you understand.
Notegera.
It is not the suit which preaches.
A suit si ebulira enjiri.
You get the message through my mouth.
Obubaka obufuna okuva mu kamwa
kange. But I have to package the message well.
Nina okwambaza obubaka buno bulungi.
For the glory of God.
Kulwekitiibwa kya Katonda.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
Lwaki tugula bino?
Why do we buy all these things?
Lwaki tukola ebintu ebirungi?
Why do we do beautiful things?
Nacho kitundu kukusumululwa.
It is part of deliverance.
Why do we encourage our members to put on well like her?
She's wearing a beautiful yellow. There's someone who will see her and say, so and so dresses like that.
You
have a beautiful suit.
This man has tie bulungi.
This man is wearing his
hat.
He has lines in his hair.
You see? Other guys out there will say, olaba ne kasamba asibe tie, nanga put on a tie,
nanga also wear a tie.
Do you know what happens? People out there admire us and they begin to do what we do. When they see, they glorify our God. They glorify our God. I want to encourage you. Come in the afternoon. I believe the Holy Spirit is going to help us.
He's going to help us. Even you people who are online,
air ticket.
The anointing doesn't need an air ticket.
Canada,
the anointing will get you in Canada and deliver you.
Amen.
You shall be delivered. Your children shall be delivered. Your church will be delivered. Why do you think we tell you to have hair
pieces? Even though you interpret as
pastor has a hair piece. The young men who are going to dress like this.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But
someone comes to church and your mind is
bound.
I'll not go back with these funny trousers to church. There are young men of my age who dress well and decently. Why do you bring children who graduated here? There's a mind we want to get to and impact the people to school. The people at school study. There's someone who told me, Pastor. Every day I see those people at church, those girls at church, and I didn't even know that they go to school. I was so touched. I've been seeing the roses and I didn't know that they were in school. The other one was very touched. They saw them dressed in gowns. The message started. I think I also have to educate my children. If these ones have studied, I should also study. There are so many young people that need to go to school. But they don't go to school because the people they are in don't go to school.
But when you come to church and you see these nice things,
no,
the claddings, you see these, the flowers. I think I have to put a flower in my bedroom or in my living room.
You know, take a chimuri living room yange. Whatever you see here delivers you. It changes your mind.
Why do we teach people?
We
teach them because bondage begins from the mind. If your mind is not yet free, even if you get millions of money, you will never get anything in life. Why? Do we testify? Because we are targeting people's minds. We are ministering to people's minds. Telling them, you can still make it. You can make it. Yes, you can make it.
Your mind is so important. What keeps people in bondage? Putting aside the things that we see and the things that we hear, a sorcerer can bind you.
Remotely.
You
know, sorcerers use many things. They can use point of contact.
They can just cut a small piece from your clothes
as a point of contact.
They may see where you
stand. Gave us a testimony on Friday. They told him that mzee is not easy.
And they refused to give you a part to put a road. Then they would tell them, pass through my compound. But passing through the compound, he was also wise. He's like, I think this person wants to pick the dust from my legs. This person would pass on the grass. He was afraid. But one day,
said,
let me confirm. Then he walked the dust. Then he saw. Mzee was following him. Said, let me confirm. Then he stamped someone. And he made sure that it is visible.
When
he got there, he made a turn. And he came back. And Mzee was picking that dust, putting in a polythene. So you stole my money, you cheated me. And now you want to bewitch me. And Mzee took off and went into the house.
Praise the Lord. People
can pick dust.
That's why whenever you get a new thing, a new house, a new car, bring it for dedication. We dedicate it. We give it to God. Anything given to God is protected by God. Anything given to a demon is protected by a demon. You see, when we are chasing demons, you hear demons talking. This is ours.
This one was given
to us. It means that that person was dedicated to demons.
A person can bind you when they are bewitching you.
Point of contact.
Maybe they are using a point of contact.
Point of contact.
They love using point
like
of contact. Okugeza.
Pictures.
Ebifanani.
People's voices.
Amalubozi gabantu.
Names.
Amanya.
I remember one day
Nzijukirona kulumu
when the church was still
ekanisa
young.
Poyariye chari into.
There was a signpost up there.
Waliwo akapande waliwo bweru.
Then I got a vision.
Nefuna kuolesebwa.
An old man came.
Omusajja omukadde yajja.
Nakube ekifaananyi.
And he took a photo.
Nenda okulabanga mu vision nga nziramu okulabanga ali ku side.
Then I saw on a vision.
Yenyanja.
He was on the seashores.
Ngayimidde bwati.
Standing.
Ngayozezzamu akafaananyi ako oba bita 4x4.
He had a small photo.
He spoke words,
and then he threw it in the water, and then it moved away.
Then the voice told me,
it was Neringamba.
Begin to fight.
Tandi kokurana.
Baloze kanisa.
They've bewitched your church. I went into fasting and I prayed. I thank God I was able to defeat the witchcraft. After a very short time, the people who are staying at church here told me, we usually see someone who comes and parks there in a pickup. And they stay there for an hour. We know them, they are witch doctors. And I tell them that I know that person. And I went on my knees. They did not park there again. Sometimes you ask yourself, you know, I have my photos in the album, but they disappear slowly. Some visitors come, some steal them because they love them. Some steal them because
point of
they want to use them again. And people
who
have photos in albums, they seal them. You don't remove them. Why don't you ask it from me and I give it to you? If not, at least take a photo.
Get a recent one. Why do you want that one? Some people are bad. That's why, even in this generation, if you were to give something like money to people you don't trust, use a mobile money. Even your neighbor,
you sell things,
same items, you have many customers, that person can feel bad and go to the sorcerer and say,
Jaja, but
this one is stealing my customers. Don't worry. You just get money from his hands, direct from his hands. Auntie, mpaku change.
Auntie, give me some change.
Give me 50-50.
Mpayo,
5,000.
When they give you,
jacket and azitwale wa judge.
They remove 5,000 and then they take it to the sorcerer.
Before you know it, you are not selling anything. But thank God for the power of prayer. There is power in the blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood of Jesus.
What do you have to do then?
Mwami yalinanga hardware yawe
Gayaza. Zamanu wada hardware in Gayaza.
Kulikasera ngangamba abana bwe nabale same.
When I left my workers in.
Bazene bagule ebintu essente zino ziriko omusayi ng'omuntu adira omusayi gomu naguteeka ku kibitano.
And both things, but the money that had
blood. Pakalo nagenda yo ninsaba.
Until when I went there and I prayed.
Ningamba safe in.
And I told the safe in which they put the money.
Njiteeka mu omuliro gwa Katonda.
That I put the fire of
God. Ulizona zibanateeka ngamu nga zijiddeko ebintu nga bisirina.
All the money they will put in with witchcraft, the witchcraft will be burned.
Someone can use anything to bewitch you. So, whenever you come before God, the Bible says for this very reason, the Son of God was manifested to destroy the works of the devil. That's why you have to pray every day. You can't stop them. Let them do what they want. But Jesus was manifested to destroy the works of the devil. Because there are some people who do such things when we are not aware. So don't put on the spirit of fear. Do what you're supposed to do. Every day. Wash your family. Wash your business in the blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood of Jesus. These people, the sorcerers, use the blood, the blood of animals, to offer to demons, to offer to their gods. But we don't need those that blood, because God gave us the blood of His dear Son. Let the blood of Jesus fight the blood of animals. Let the blood of Jesus fight the blood of sorcerers. Praise the Lord. There is power in the blood. Whenever you are attacked, call either the name of Jesus, because at the mention of that name all demons bow. Call the name or call the blood of Jesus. The Bible says they overcame him by the blood of the Lord. But the blood of the Lamb, there is power in the blood. There is power in the blood. Don't leave your house
without calling the blood.
Naze motoka yange n'omusayi gwa Yesu.
I wash my car with the blood of Jesus.
Mbiko nyumba yange n'omusayi gwa Yesu.
I cover my house with the blood of Jesus.
Bedroom yange. Abana bange mbabika musayi gwa Yesu.
I cover them in the blood of Jesus.
When you are sleeping and a sorcerer does something, the demons will come. When they see the blood, they cannot park there. It happened in the Bible. In the days of Moses, God told Moses,
tell them to ask for the
to slaughter
the lamb and put the blood.
When the angel of death came, there's no parking. No parking, no parking. Like that. The blood saved them. But we thank God for our day. God provided a lamb. That is Jesus Christ. When you cover your home with the blood of Jesus, when sickness comes, problems come, when they see the blood, they continue. When they see the blood, they continue. Cover your office with the blood. Cover yourself with the blood. Every day you need to use the blood of Jesus in order to be free, because sorcerers are not seated
all the time.
They are driven by jealousy. When they see something good in your family, they want to destroy it, because the devil came to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But thank God for Jesus. He came that you may have life and have it in abundance. You'll have money in abundance. You'll have cows, many cows, everything in abundance, in the name of Jesus. Don't worry. The blood of Jesus is greater than the demons of Tanzania. You know, in East Africa, people fear witchcraft from Tanzania. But But I've been in deliverance for more than 20 years. I've seen the power of God. Breaking spirits. Chasing demons. And it will continue. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have to be free. The Bible says when the Son sets you free, you become free indeed. Captivity.
Obuwambe.
Captivity.
Obuwambe.
And bondage.
No busibe.
Binji nyumba lokole.
It is a lot among the born again.
Olaba abantu.
You see people.
Nga buli kimu akirina.
They have everything.
Nga hina hi.
But then you're like,
lwaki kino kigaana?
Why is this failing?
Ogenda n'osanga abantu nga musumba.
You may find people.
They checked me.
Musumba bankebera. I have the ability to give birth. But why? There's something that has stopped the children from coming into your womb.
Only the power of God
has
the answer for that. But what I learned with godly things, until you believe them, they will never work for you. That's why we need to teach. Now, there are people who come in churches and they see people falling like jumping like popcorns. What kind of power is that? Now, the man is seated, he is standing here, and then a person flies.
And then they kick.
Now, Papa, what is that?
Gamba, Papa, checho.
We call that demonstration of God's power.
Okutukuyita okulagibwa kwa manyi ga Katonda.
Amen. Omuntu ayinza okuvaka emizimu.
Some the demons may get off a person. The demons can go but then they return.
Lwaki?
Why?
Tayigirizidwa.
Because they have not been taught.
Mizimu gisobola okuvaka.
Demons can get off of you.
Olumuna goba. One day
I think there were demons, hired demons, because I had a voice say so.
They were talking.
Jari jogera.
And then when I overpowered them, they said, okay, let us leave
here and let us wait for them
there.
And then they said, will you be with them at home?
I said, I
will not be there, but at least I've chased you. But they were lying to me. The devil can lie. Those demons never came back. They never possessed her again.
I'm
here to tell you, there's power in prayer. So when you see those demons that get off of people, why is it that some return? Because those people have never committed themselves to God. How do you commit yourself to God?
In times we say,
we
sing, I surrender all.
Tuyimba nti byonna mbiwaayo.
Not some, but all.
Sebimo naye byonna.
Some people can say, I'm born again.
Abantu abo bagamba nti ndi mulokole.
Ninge bimu tabiwaddeyo.
But they've never surrendered certain things.
You surrender the foot.
Owaayo.
And the hands are still being used by the devil.
Owaayo bigere naye nge mikono stani akyagikozesa.
You surrender the body, but the mind is still in the world.
Owaayo mubiri naye nge birowoozo bibikyali mu nsi.
If you are like that,
bobanga oli bwotyo,
demons will run and come back.
Emizimu gijja kudduka ate gikomewo.
Some people,
abantu abamu,
have never fully committed themselves.
Tebewangayo bonna bonna.
Today they are in church.
Olwaleero bali mu kanisa.
Tomorrow in the shrine.
Enkya bali mu masabo.
Why did you go to the shrine?
Oh, kama ate kakati lwaki ogenda mu masabo.
You know, Papa, teyajja kudibya byansi.
You know, Jesus did not come to remove the
you
things
know,
of the world.
My dad told me that we should go there.
Because,
you know, Papa, that shrine belongs to our judge.
Papa, umanye sabero ya judge wa fe.
There's no problem.
Tewali buzibu bonna.
Then
you look at the dog.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You are not yet serious with your life.
Tonaba kubera serious na bulamu
bo. The devil came to kill
Stani yajja
your life.
Bulamu bo.
Your life.
Bulamu bo.
Even your spirit.
No moyo.
Deva yagala spirit yegene muliro.
The devil wants your spirit to go into the fire.
We are here.
But this is not our final destination. God has to take you further ahead.
The anointing
amafuta
can break and destroy the
gasobola okumenya era negazikiriza ekikoligo.
Njagala mubeke ebibuzo bye mubuuza bitono.
I want you to ask a few questions
because I thought that I have to share
kubanga
before we reach that session.
Bade manye nti nina okubaako byengabanako nammwe nga titunaba kutuuka mu kaseera kali.
And maybe some people may
obaoliawo
abamu babadde tebabikkiririza.
Some people are not even believing in it.
I know so many.
You can be bound in with poverty until when you die.
Problems.
You can be there. You
be
a poor. And you go to heaven like Lazarus.
It is a Lazarus who died and was lifted by angels.
And then he went to heaven. How many want to be like Lazarus? No one has raised their hand. So if you don't want to be like Lazarus, allow the bondage, the anointing to break the bondage.
You can live with wealth and still go to heaven. If you have wealth, you will serve God properly. You will not grumble. And even your children will go to school because you have money to take them to school. But if you say that, when I go to heaven, I will meet my money there. Okay. Now we
also thank God for you. You can be there.
But Jesus
when
said,
you get to heaven, you get the money. Let your will be done in heaven.
And Jesus said, you will receive 100-fold here. And 100-fold there. You have to receive your 100-fold before you die. I
want to see my heaven on earth
before
I see heaven up there.
The blessing
omukisa
which God is going to give you,
Katonda gwagenda kuwa,
is going to give you
gugenda,
at least a manifestation
kuletera at least
of the heavens you are aspiring for.
Kugenda kulaga eguru lyoyagala tukako.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Manyingo genda mu guru.
I know that you're going to go to heaven. But I want to go to first make heaven on earth. It's just that you people don't travel. Ask those people who live in Abu Dhabi. Those people who live in
Dubai.
The first day I went to Dubai. I said, God gave these men their heaven. They don't complain.
Arabs,
you
created your heavens here. And then I came back to the born again and I said,
why don't we believe God? And we also make heaven on earth. Just like the Arabs have done it. And you come out of the heaven on earth. And you go to heaven. But it comes from your perception. Today I'm going to pray for you. I pray that God will bless you. That you'll get into your earthly heaven. That is your 100-fold on earth. But even those Arabs, history says that they haven't even made 60 years when they've done that. They've not been like that. The first time they showed me the old buildings in Dubai. And I said, this is where they were. I saw buildings that I saw in Nakasaja. And I said, but how did it happen?
These people would give them money and give them
exposure.
When you get money,
bofuna sente,
you can go anywhere in America.
Osobro genda wantu wona, osobro genda mu America.
Mubango limuntu ayiga.
If you're someone who learns,
ngowe gomba, ngoyiga,
and you admire things and you learn,
sente,
and you have money,
osobro okulabe chino chegoma no chikole uo.
You can see something and you admire it and you do it at your home.
Nebo bango limu sibe,
but if you're bound,
tosobora,
you cannot.
Kati banuba Maria baba deke Sweden.
So the Marias who have lived in Sweden,
nibabeirake London,
namawanga
amalala,
lived in London and in other countries.
Paris,
they travel to Paris and everywhere. She has been able
Entebbe
to make a palace in Entebbe. If she was bound, even if you see those things,
I
saw Maria's house and in Intinda, and I praised God.
I sold it.
When she told me in Nyumba, you
know,
she told me, I said, this woman has killed us. The things were beautiful. But when I went to Entebbe, I said,
this lady can
Chalono
see
very far.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Katonda wa Maria,
the God of Maria,
asobolo kuba Katonda,
can be your God.
Asobolo kuba Katonda,
can be your God.
Amisoga,
Mr. Nsubuga,
Katonda wa asobolo kuba Katonda wa Tina.
Your God can be Tina's God.
Katonda wa Sarah,
as Sarah's God,
asobola kuba Katonda wa Tina,
can be Tina's God.
Katonda yazimbira Sarah kalina,
a God who built for Sarah a storied house,
asobola kuzimbira,
can also build it for
He's
you.
Not a respectable person.
Tasosola mu bantu.
Chiva mukulaba.
It comes from your perception.
Abantu bana Uganda tiwaliwe batali.
There's Ugandans
Nigeria,
are everywhere. They're in
Nigeria,
they're in Ghana,
South Africa,
they're in South Africa,
they are in Europe, different countries in Europe. Ugandans are all over
Uganda, but
they get lots of money, but when they come back to Uganda,
welcome home, Uganda,
you
see the house they've built after getting money from those nations,
describing
you cannot even describe that they've ever lived there.
Bondage.
Bosibe.
You can't move.
Tosobola kutambula.
You can't do anything.
Toyina chosobola kola.
When you see something,
bolabe chintu
the devil deletes it.
Stani achisangula.
You forget.
No chera bira.
When you see something,
bobako chola.
You begin to fear.
Otandiko kutia.
How can I do it?
Zeninza ncho chikola.
I don't have that money.
Sina sente ezo.
Yet it's not you, but
Atenga
the grace of God.
Nekisa cha Katonda.
The grace of God.
Nekisa cha Katonda.
Not you, but God is grace.
Sigwe nekisa cha Katonda.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I want to give two, three people to ask. Then we shall conclude. When I conclude, I will ask, where is your husband? Madina.
Madina.
Banencha, they are flying out of this country.
Banencha, ba vamugwanga lino bagenda kulinya.
Nemanyinga jemugenda mulenda kulaba
omukisa. But I know that you're going to see a blessing where you're going.
When I took a makaga mu Abu Dhabi,
when I got to your home in Abu Dhabi,
namanya nti mu mwawo bomukisa,
I knew that you people were blessed.
Omuntu ngo yingira mukali na apartment Abu Dhabi.
If someone has an apartment,
binabiro, diro,
in Abu Dhabi, they have bathrooms and a sitting room. You're like, they have these things when they're here. It's like they're living in Uganda.
The same blessing is going to follow you where you are
going.
You're
not slaves. You're not bound. You just need a blessing. The God who has been with you is going to continue being with you. You need to first come. Tomorrow they are boarding, they are going to Europe.
Anyi gatoke kali musoke mudeyo tumulinde. Tumulindeko. You remember their testimony?
Mujukira obujulizi bwabwe.
You remember? God
is going to work for you too. Don't worry. Don't take offense.
They were from up there.
They got a Schengen visa. They got a Schengen visa.
They are able to travel 27 countries in Europe. They can settle in any of their choice. That's what they got. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But that lady is a lady of faith.
Because
when I stood in their home,
I said,
"We
want to travel," and I said, "I've given it to you."
He
said, "Pastor, gave it to us."
We
have to go.
And
they started processing their documents. The three of them were given. And tomorrow they are leaving Africa.
They
are going to start a journey.
Amina.
Amen.
Kati chocho chilale cho mafuta.
That is different. That is
Richard, romantic. Richard, come and come here.
Richard,
ask
Jango.
Your question.
Wuzo.
Come here and ask. Obusibe. No, obuambe. Oluganda lwa ukana.
Kama ibasiwe kanisa.
No, obusibe. Jangwa.
Captivity and bondage.
Are you in captivity or you are in bondage?
Kama hewa zibe church.
Amen.
Amanya zika ganda Richard.
That is his name.
Kati mzei nze chibuzo chembuza.
Mzei my question is.
Ma obusibe.
Bondage.
Mbuyingi la munti ya.
How do I get into bondage? Am I born with it?
Mbuyingi la munti ya. Nzali wana abuo.
Or captivity.
Mbambu funabu funyinga. Mbulambu nunga antambula.
Am I born as a captive or I get it into
bondage? Nyinzo kubanga nina. Ebiroto byange.
Second question.
Ebiroto byange byenjagala okutuukako.
I may have
dreams
and aspiration, but I'm born again.
Naye ne ntambula nga ndaba sirituukako.
Oyinza kuba olina ki?
Ebiroto.
Ebiroto byo.
Ebiroto byange oba ebiruliwa byange.
Oh my goals.
Naye nga ndaba sirituukako
nga ndi mulokole. But I'm not achieving them even if I'm born again.
Kati manya anti. Ebiro byange tebinnatuuka.
How do I know that my seasons are not yet?
Wacha ntya mu biro byange.
Oh, how do I?
N'obusibe. Okumanya nti oba ndi mubi ebiro tebinnatuuka mukama tanatusa kunkolera ebyo.
How do I know that God has not yet?
It's
not yet time for God to work.
Praise the Lord.
Mukama yebazibwa.
Bobanga oli musibe.
If you're bound.
Bino byonna byonna ebiro bivenako.
Leave, put aside all these things of seasons. Even the dreams you'll never see.
Bobanga bakugula.
If you were bought.
You are in someone's home. You had a dream of getting a bachelor's. You
were
in people and your father was taken as captive with his family.
Now,
you begin to work as slaves.
Can you think that you can even achieve a bachelor's degree? You no longer go to school.
You are not studying.
So,
which means
chitegeza.
You are not able to get a degree.
Kufuna na degree.
Kat brother chabuza.
So what the brother is asking.
Mwabali ne biroto.
You people have dreams.
Ebiroto wasoba ngoli musibe biroto viveko.
As long as you're bound, leave the dreams. You will never achieve that dream.
Nebiro bituka nebiyitawo.
Even the seasons come and the season bypass you.
Kubanga oli mukomera.
Because you're in prison. If they put you in prison and they tell you we are going to put you in prison for 50 years and you're 15 years at that time, can you tell me that you can get married? Will you get married while in prison? We have to first break down the prison walls and you come out and then your dreams will start to manifest. So he has asked, how do I get into bondage? Some bondages were entered into by our parents and were born into them. For us, we are children. And then you find yourself. You're also bound. So you have to look for someone to deliver you. If you fail to get them, you still remain a
Kati abalokole chibatamanyi.
So that is what the born again don't
Yaga
know. For them they say if I become
Biona
born again, everything is going to work themselves out. But that is not how it is.
Jesus spoke to Lazarus.
Yes, he
said, Lazarus, come forth.
Vayo.
Lazarus came.
Lazarus na
vayo. Do you know what Jesus told the disciples? The Peter. Untie him. Not me, but you. Untie him.
Untie
him. You have the power to untie. Me,
I've resurrected them. For me, I've caused them
now,
to accept salvation.
You break the chain. We have the power to break the chain through teaching and demonstration of God's power. We first teach and then demonstrate. That's why people like Pastor Tom Mugerwa, he teaches, after teaching, then demonstrate. It is very easy to bring a pastor here
now
demonstrating an emugwari.
And he demonstrates and you all get slain.
Demons can be shaken and go.
But if what bound you to them
they
has
come
not
back.
Been uprooted, jikomao.
So we have to teach you not only godly things,
maybe
but
even things of daily life.
So
if someone doesn't know, how will they develop?
We'll teach you how to save. Teach your children how to save money. This pig bank, give you a pig bank now. When I give you 50,
work
or tithe, get
1,000
and save
it.
At the end of the year, I'll buy you a bicycle from this
bank.
Teach them. There are
some people who have not been taught why they should come early. Why they should be early. Why they should come out of their house
early.
Even if you don't have a job, wake up early and come out of your house. The moment you wake up, you need to open your windows so that there is fresh air.
Number two, you've
woken up in the morning
before
7 a.m. Don't make your bed. You need to first open it. Who has understood? Open your bed to aerate it. Open the windows widely. Amen. Come out. Run around.
Senya.
Brush your teeth.
What
do you have to eat in the morning?
Not yams.
Simayoni.
Ah, Papa, I had my yams. Yep.
Sumbanze, nina wana mayuni gange.
I have to eat my yams.
Nina kuria mayuni gange.
Before I slept, I prayed for these yams.
Nabade sinaba kweba kanasabida mayuni gange.
Don't start with yams.
Totandika na mayuni.
You start with what, Dr. Katumba?
Otandika na chi, Dr. Katumba.
Preferably warm water in the morning.
Then.
And then if you have a fruit around, it's better you start with a fruit.
Fruit.
Praise the Lord. Why?
Rachi.
Because in the morning, when we are eating in the morning, tugamant, it is a breakfast.
Tugamant, no,
we are breaking the fast. When you are asleep, it's like you've
been fasting.
So you have to break the fast with warm water and a fruit. Then when you take a fruit, take 5 minutes
as you do
other
things.
Don't
first eat and eat and eat. And.
Oh, pack it up, pick up. Ooh, what? Papa, pray for me.
Papa Nsabira.
The demon entered here.
Uzimu
and it is,
wano.
It is Kati. Moving around.
Weto olora.
That is not a demon.
Ogo simu zimu.
You are not taught well.
Toyigirizi dwa burunji.
Early in the morning.
Kumacha.
You know, umuntu anzo kubambu sibe miaka jejona.
Someone can be in bondage all their years.
Pastor,
my children are not looking healthy.
You
give them leftovers in the morning.
Panji. Nibalio kabafuna poti berries.
Then they bafuna obubuto bwabwe ne buzimba.
Envili ne zimyuka.
Then they get a brown hair.
Then you bring them to church, Papa.
I want to know about it. I'm
going to
say, Pastor, you see how I'm feeding my children.
They have money now. They look like these rich people. These rich people. And Lisa.
Because of what you're feeding
them.
We have to teach everything. The way people brush their teeth. Some people brush their teeth, but they don't brush their tongue. You have to clean your tongue. After you brush your teeth, clean also your tongue. Wake up. Open your bed. Open your windows. Go out and walk around. As you do other things.
Then
come
out.
Then come
back.
When your place has been aerated, then lay your bed and cover it. Close the windows because you're going to work. You come back when your house is fresh. The people who say the neighbors here are gossip. I don't even want them to see what is in my sitting room. They will steal my mats.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. I got my mats and baskets from Kabubu.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we need to teach people. Teach people how to make friends. How to keep friends. You don't know how to keep friends. You people, you are here.
Bantu
you don't make friends.
Mikwano.
When we give you a responsibility to be an usher, instead of using that position to make friends, you create enemies. Make friends. When you get a friend, keep that friendship through communication. We are very busy, but at least hello. Good night. Good morning. That is enough to keep your friendship.
For me, I know they love me.
5 months.
Years 8 and I know they know me. Every day we meet new people. But if you want to remain in the same position, keep yourself there.
And the Baganda say,
Abaganda bagamba,
omukwano ogubulwa eyeguya,
a friendship with no one who stoops low,
teguangara,
does not last. If you don't stoop low for someone, you have to stoop low for friendship. Even if
they've not greeted
them, greet them. How are you, Oriotia?
Kati doctor, laba abantu bangi.
So doctor, you meet so many people. Where you are in hospital. And in your hospital, you meet so many people.
And we meet nice people.
To think an abantu abalungi.
Kati gono we sanganga gona sanga mu 2020.
And you find that the person you met in 2020. You're very.
Ne tumanyi communication.
Good, but tumanyi kuogereziganya n'abantu.
Nebufuko obusibe.
And it becomes a bondage.
Eri abantu abalanga tumanyi kuyiga. Tumwagala kuyiga bipya.
You don't want to learn new things.
Enima jo wali manga mwira cho chali mama.
The same way you used to farm is the same way you're still farming.
Omusajja agenda mu conferences inali emmere yenja
bulo. The man goes to conferences and eats different kinds of food.
Kuyiga bipya.
For you don't want to learn new things.
Enfumba jo wafumba nga mujo cha
fumba. The same way you used to cook before is the same way you're still cooking now.
Wafumba nga ngo olie nanga bo.
The same way you used to cook when you are in nanga.
Wafumbirwe machi ndero cha fumba mfumba ye nanga.
You got married in machi and now you're still cooking as though you're in nanga bo.
She's a Muchiga girl.
There's a girl I love, Muchiga.
I call her a program. She has a program called that girl. Doreen Nasasira. Who knows Doreen Nasasira?
Anyamani Doreen.
You know her? Mumu following.
Do you follow her?
Doreen Nasasira, aliku spark.
She was on spark the other time.
Bulikasera yagala okuyiga.
But all the time she wants to learn. That is what I love about her. Every dish.
Agama to fule amakaga fetuga fule ajifula. A restaurant. Yeah? A what? 5-star hotel.
To fula makaga five-star hotel.
To fumbenga.
She wants us to cook
hotel.
Like the chefs who cook in those 5-star hotels.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yesterday I was viewing her.
Eguro nabade mulaba.
Yatambude na agenda e Mulungu.
She traveled and went to
Mulungu, Mulungu there in Gaba.
Egaba.
And met a certain lady.
Nasinka no mchalo omo.
Yechenyanja achocha bocha.
For her she
smokes the fish. Bakola batya.
And then she asked her, why isn't it getting burnt? You know the spices and everything.
This girl is good.
She also has something she instills among her followers. They learn new things every day. So she learned, and I saw her learning. Yet every day she's always been sharing what she learned. What if you also learn how to smoke the fish? And your husband comes back, and he finds when you've smoked the fish. And he passes, you know, when he returns, the cup of bushera.
Amina.
Amen.
Some
of it is bondage, and you lose your home and your marriage because you're not creative. This flower, your husband wanted it. Learn it and place, put it in place.
Teach your children to pray. Teach them. Sit with them. Come.
But when they come back,
say sorry.
Wetonde.
It
is you people to teach your children those things. Learn to dress. Learn to dress well. In this world, God did not create any ugly person. You know, beauty comes because you care for yourself. If you don't know how to dress well, there are people who know about styling. Hire them and let them do it for you. You wear makeup and you don't know how to put it. Go to the saloon and allow an expert do your makeup. All your makeup is flowing on your face. People will tell you what looks good on you and what doesn't. He went and now he's seeing other women. You're the flower.
You are not a flower. You are no longer a flower. Kale, you were flower.
Oh, kale orichimuri.
Kale, you were flower, but you were withered flower.
Na yo orichimuri echao toka.
You were withered flower.
Orichimuri echao toka.
Why don't you tune yourself?
Rush to wait it is.
Tulina abantu
mu kibugo omwo. We have people in the city.
Nga asobola kukwambaza.
They can dress you up.
Naga ma misses. This is good on your body.
Mrs. Chino chinyo miro mubiri ku.
Amen.
Amen.
Kati ndoza mwete mchari kubiri ebiyo gamba nti. Nange ni no kubiri omweru unga nuru.
I think you people are no longer on things like, you know, I also have to be light skinned like Noor. You don't need to lighten yourself.
Kwa musumatu ulideba nange njiri ya kwa Yerusa. Jike harirudda.
Don't you dare lighten yourself, your skin.
Bera chori.
Be in your color.
Where you gotta appreciate yourself.
Love yourself. Where see me.
Bajja kusomesa.
They will teach you. I will tell you what I know. What I know is what I tell you.
Baku yise ask.
You've been invited, Boza.
We are going to the beach.
Okay, na ku beach.
Dress code.
Yeah, to ambala tutia. Baja kuyigiriza.
I know when the spirit tells me to put on a gomes and kakondo, I will just come.
Nze nja kujabuzi.
Tujia kula. You will remove your shoes when we go there.
Oja kujamu enga tozo rampa. Kanga tugenze. You can't go to the beach in
high
heels. How will you step in the sand?
I have to put on my gomas.
Because you're very argumentative. When they invite you somewhere,
so,
you need to first ask, what is the dress code?
How are we going to put on?
How are we going to put on? How do you want me to dress?
Some people
buy their new sandals. They want to go with them to the wedding.
Because
they want...
Oba kitegeera Ogenu kwa muntu nga yerete de chinu uche. Mugenze kukwanda.
Someone is wearing.
Akubagana ne chinu. But you are laughing. That is the community we are living in. We have to teach people. Okwambala decently.
Okwambala obulungi nga tewesitaza abantu.
Decently.
Nga tewesitaza abantu.
Omanya nti church ebera church.
You not a kanisa eba
kanisa. Church wegwa.
After church.
Ogenze out with your friends.
Emekwano
jo. You put on your shorts.
Oli watembo kwambala ebintu byo shorts zo.
But you are very smart.
And I already smart in you.
My shorts.
In your shorts.
Neto zeta mchana.
But don't bring the shorts in church.
Walona buno obuntu wano ba sister bwatero kwa
ambara. Even certain things the sisters wear.
Buno obukwate nyo ku mubiri babuyita bwana. Jeggings, leggings. Obulaba anga abantu bazze babwesaze mu deliverance.
You see people coming in deliverance.
Bo muzimu akukuba njya kujja ne chiwoko nsoke nkukube.
Because they praised you that you were smart.
You
think that you'll even come in church in your jeggings and leggings. You think we don't have them.
This is church.
We leave them there.
This is church.
Someone is selling his
coat.
We are going to meet my mother. They also have them.
Put on decently.
But wabango kinambaza dobo yambara
burundi. I've already told my mother that you are my best friend.
Katinze ngambe mama ange gwe mkwanu
gwe. That you are putting on jeggings, leggings.
Ojide mu
leggings. You should not put on like that when you're in church.
Kwambala bwoto ngo jja mu kanisa.
Leggings?
Mu jeggings.
Jeggings?
Mu leggings ne jeggings tochigeza.
But on parties?
Naye ku party oli wa dembe.
Parties, your friend.
Obubaga bonna oli wa dembe.
It depends which party.
Chisinzira kabaga chi.
Amen.
Amina.
Walone nebi nebi tuwebi mu biyo noku okubedanga oyigirizibwa.
There even some things you have to be taught.
You are putting on white here.
Oyamba tebiyeru wano.
This is gold. This is silver.
No silver, no gold.
And here you want to be like an Asian. You are putting on something. Don't. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We need such lessons. One day, we shall get time to teach all this.
How should someone lay their bed?
Walinga mu senior secondary school.
Wali mu somero lyo.
Ngamwala sumbusa.
You know, you would lay your
bed.
You fold your bed sheet and the blanket, and then you. When someone is tired and they're going to sleep, they have to unfold. And then they lay the bed again. Even go to people's homes, even the curtains. The part that should have been facing the outside is facing inside. You find someone, the bedsheet that will be on top is laid on the mattress. The coat that would have gone to office, or a suit, a party suit. They work in their party wear. You've gone to apply for a job. And you've gone for an interview, but you're wearing jeans. Someone will tell you there's no job.
You that, have you seen my papers? No, I've seen your papers.
But the way you're dressing does not show that you're serious. You've come to apply for a job. Dress well. Wear your suit well if you're a woman.
Dress yo.
Wear your dress. Look someone in the eyes. Speak to them. You've come to apply for a job. You want to be a receptionist.
What is your name?
Where
are you staying?
Kabanyoro. I'll tell you, we'll get back to you.
Message. You'll be good day. I want to end here. Thank you so much for listening. We need teachings in all areas. The Holy Spirit is there and the anointing is here.
Mtukufu wali, amafuta wegari.
But we lack knowledge.
Naete tuina kumanya.
Mukufumba.
Cooking.
Mukutambula.
Traveling. We'll talk about those things another time.
You are chewing.
We gaya gaya.
Is this a human being or a goat?
No, muntu oba mbuzi.
Did you know chewing?
When should you chew? And where?
Did you know chewing?
When should you chew?
Nadi. Nawa.
And where should you chew from?
You are talking.
You get
a respectable person.
No muto wechitiwa.
Stand still.
Yimirira mutengerere.
If not,
boba
according to the culture,
ukusinzira ku bulombolombo oba culture somulo fukamira.
You may not kneel.
Oyinza obutafukamira.
But still.
Naye no yimirira bulungi.
You show respect.
Ojja kubalaga obukakamu n'ekitiibwa.
The voice you use,
eddoboozi ly'okozesa,
the kind of words you use,
ebigambo by'okozesa.
Eri abantu abamu abalina favor.
There are people who have favor.
Butcha.
How?
Tasobola kugera na muntu nga tagambye sa.
They cannot speak
Mr. Mrs.
with anyone nga tebataddeko nti
yesebo
yenyabo ye professor.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
Ekyokka kikuleetera favor omuntu naye.
Only that can bring you favor and someone listens to you the more.
Olw'okubanga.
But because
wakula ne Mwami Katumba.
You grew up with Mr. Katumba.
Ero mulaba bulabi wa Katumba oliyote.
Katumba, how are you?
But then njagala nayo ku mirimu ewuweyo bangambi olina emirimu.
Katumba, they told me you have job opportunities.
Katumba, wakula dano kwa.
Katumba, you're already grown up.
Kala akakamanyiro.
You see that familiarity.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Omuntu yenna bw'aba akuze n'awasa n'okuwasa.
If someone has grown up and married and studied,
ekitiibwa ekyo
that honor
olina okukikozesa
and respect you have to use it.
Kikimuleetera okujjula kubanga yakikolerera.
It is what causes them to be full because they worked for it.
Akamanyira akali mbalokola akuyita sister.
Familiarity among the born again, they call everyone sister.
Nakuyita dda erinnya lye bakuyita mukyalo.
They call you the very name they call you in the village.
Bwe tujje ne Kampala agamanya mugeesigalize.
When we come to Kampala, stay with those names.
Nze mpita Dennis, that is enough.
Call me Dennis, ekyo kimmala.
Anji. Nze mbabuulidde mulekera okuyita bannammwe amannya gali. Okujjako era ng'olijjuza ng'olitaddeko ekitiibwa kyo.
Unless you put the title
so and so.
On them to ba mwami gundi ne gundi.
So and so.
Mukyala gundi ne gundi.
Like that.
Bwe kityo.
That is how you will get favor from people.
Bw'otyo n'obujja ofuna okuganja okuva mu bantu.